As you know, for some years, we have been discussing the housing crunch, the housing crisis affecting the city and the state of New York. In fact, that is a crisis that has been ripping neighborhoods apart. And right at the center of it is the cost of rent and affordability. We have also been very critical that the settlements that have taken place between the Attorney General's office, the New York State Attorney General's office, and the banking and financial institutions in Wall Street that engaged in risky business resulting in a financial collapse, a close financial collapse of our economy, that the settlement money that we have gotten for several years have gone elsewhere outside of the epicenter of the housing crisis, primarily to some of the counties outside of New York City. But we are happy to see that in this budget, $600 million of that settlement money is coming towards the Division of Housing and Community Renewal for the purpose of affordable housing. And so we are hopeful that that $1.9 billion will result in the creation and the construction of affordable housing, and that when the MOU is reached between the director of the budget and the three leaders, that in fact, through that agreement, we may be able to get some funding for NYCHA. As you know, last year we allocated $100 million for the first time in over a decade to the NYCHA network of complexes that are facing a $17 billion deficit and are facing critical challenges, infrastructure and capital project challenges throughout the city of New York. So we're hopeful that when that MOU is reached, that NYCHA is given the ability to access some of this capital funding to the tune perhaps of $100 million for the next 5 years. I am also pleased to see that in the original Senate resolution, there was a $2.5 million allocation that has been traditionally included for the Hudson River Park Trust that I represent along with Senator Holman, and that in fact this was zeroed out in the resolution, but we're happy to see that this budget includes it and it was restored. For those reasons, Mr. President, I will be voting in the affirmative.